show you down the hull here. You can see it's nice and shiny, straight. There's a guard. It's a paint-on guard, just on the edge. It's just for where you pull traps and lines in. It was put on there original, and just saves the corner of the boat from getting chipped up and dinged up. It's a 2013 99. 2010-250. Stripers don't come with those side gunnels. I had those made and installed. They're aluminum, then powder coated white. All the enclosures in great shape, no rips or tears. Glass is still clean. Got a rear light there, it's got two lights on the front as well. There's a live well here. Got a pump. I don't use it because I don't have we don't use live bait, so I usually just store fish in here. But it's got a drain, pumps out. I've got a high pressure 70 psi washdown hose right there with the switch. Two brand new gel cell batteries. More room for storage under there if you had something you wanted to hide. Self-baling deck. A little bit of dirt around the drains. Just we've had some rain and it washes everything into the corners. But works well. Side gunnels on this side as well. This is the fuel tank. So there's a silicone or seal around it. As you see, there's a couple marks from where the silicone eventually starts to discolor. Wouldn't be a big job if the guy was really picky about it, or when the time comes to replace that, but it's sealed, it works fine, there's no water that gets through to the hull. Took the original striper seats, put them here, they're on swivels, so two people can sit comfortably, and upgraded to the temper seats for the driver and passenger. Again, no rips, tears, nothing like that, they're all very clean. No delamination. That's the remote for the kicker, full tilt and trim. Electric start, of course, so you can run the kicker from the helm here. Fly-by-wire controls for the big motor, so no more shifting cables or throttle cables. It's all done electronically. Very smooth LCX-110 goes in there. Yamaha digital controls, you can watch your fuel speed and consumption there. Up top there's a VHF radio and a stereo there with a couple speakers mounted on each side. And the Furano radar, which used to be up top, but I like the visibility down here better. Could be moved back up there if you don't use the radar very often. We tend to get fog here. I just got some. These things are just velcroed on at the top here. They just pull off. It's a place to keep a few pliers and sunglasses and stuff. both motors are connected by the new system that SeaStar has, that cable you see running between them, so there's no more tie bars or solid bars between them, or those goofy ones that were on the back. You can tilt either motor, or up or down, either one, they both just turn together, it doesn't matter. That's the rear steering station right here, so you can steer both motors from the back of the boat for your fishing. Got the cuddy loaded since the pitches were taken, so it's going to be full down there, but we'll show you what we got. Let's see, everything's very clean, white, no marks or scratches. There's a little stove that goes in there, alcohol burning stove. A sink, fresh water tank, it's about 6 gallons, I think. The PVC piping you see here just pops out. I just put it there so when I'm traveling, my bins of stuff don't fall off onto the floor. Hang my extra jackets and survival stuff there. Upgraded to an electric flush toilet. They come just with a porta potty originally. So you just turn the switch and out she goes. I've got the table and other goodies that came with this thing originally. It's never been used. Lots of storage on that side. On this side. Underneath both seats. In the center here is a great big fish tub or storage locker for whatever you want it for. And underneath both seats as well. The seats just lift out of there. Very easy to get out. And you can store extra goods under there. Access to the sending unit for the fuel tank and whatnot there, so you don't have to take everything out if you have an issue. One last look at the outside. Just been waxed, so it's every year it gets waxed and put away in a heated shop for the winter. Sits great in the water, rides great, cruises at, I usually cruise around 30 miles an hour, it'll do 45, 46 topped out, but at 30 you get pretty good fuel economy and you're making good speeds, so. And it's easy on the motor.